lift your hips off the ground, place that block underneath your pelvis. So depending on how deep of a back bend you can come into, you might be at the lowest height, the middle height, or maybe the highest. Placing the block right at the crest of the buttocks, right at the sacroiliac. Rolling those shoulders towards one another, and then resting your arms to the floor, or you can also interlace your fingers, wrapping your arms around the block if flexibility permits that. Really feeling those shoulder blades tucked together, lifting your chest towards your chin, lengthening through the back of the neck. You don't want to move your head around with this one. Keep your nose pointing towards the ceiling. As your neck is a little precarious, it is supporting some of your body's weight. Feeling your breath move deep into the belly. This is a counter pose to all of that core work. So you're lengthening, you're releasing the abdominal wall. Let your breath carry the belly up. You can choose to stay as you are with the knees bent, or you can walk your feet further out in front, straightening out the legs. The toes will likely lift off the ground, but you can point the toes towards the floor. You can go in the direction of straight, or you can fully extend if that's available to you. And remember that that's optional. You can choose to keep your knees bent. If your legs are extended, bend back through the knees, walking your feet in closer to the block. And then if you're already on the lowest level of the block, the lowest height, then stay as you are. If you're at the middle or the highest, adjust that block down to the lowest, and then resting your pelvis upon it. All right, so we're gonna do one more set of those leg lifts, having the hips raised this time. That's gonna create even more length through the lumbar. Walk your feet in close together, squeeze those inner thighs, squeeze the big toes, palms pressing alongside your hips for a little bit of support and balance. In this first round, try it with the heels lifted already, just the toes touching down. Take an inhale there, and on your exhale, lift your feet off the floor, knees up over your hips. Inhale to lower your feet down. Maybe you attempt the flat footing. Exhale to lift the feet up. We're gonna keep the knees bent for these first few rounds. Inhaling to lower with control, exhaling to lift. Take the energy out of the shoulders. Keep breathing. Seeing if you can isolate the energy in the transverse abdominals. Just two more, almost there. And the next time you lift your feet, keep them floating. You might stay there with the knees bent. You might extend through your legs. No matter where you're choosing to be, I'm gonna distract you from the core work by getting into the ankles a bit. On your inhale, point through your toes. Exhale, flex your feet, lifting the heels up. Inhale, pointing the toes. You can also do this with your knees bent. Exhale to flex. Inhaling, pointing. And exhale to flex. Last round like that. And the next time you point the toes, keep the toes pointed, and then circle your feet around. So we're moving into the ankles. The feet can move in the same direction or in opposite directions, whatever occurs naturally. And then switching directions. And pointing back to the toes, lift the feet up a little higher. Bending through your knees, lower your feet to the floor, and then walk your feet in close together, open your knees apart, coming into those butterfly legs, letting the knees sink towards the ground with the hips slightly elevated. You're gonna get more action in those inner thighs. This actually stretches out that transverse abdominal area that we've just worked so hard. Simply letting yourself hang. Can you relax the belly, no longer trying to hold your legs up, but instead of letting them flop open. And then bringing your legs together, pressing your feet to the floor. Lift your hips off of the block, remove that block, place it off to the side. Take just a breath or two with the hips still lifted. Taking control of the spine back into your muscles. And then slowly lower down. Then walk your feet mat distance apart, so the knees are apart, and knock knee the knees together. So letting the thighs and knees rest into one another to release your low back. So knees are hanging in, feet are wide apart. Keeping the feet still mat distance apart, open the knees apart, and then windshield wiper your knees. So the legs will not be touching here. Just letting the legs rock from side to side. This is less of a twist, more of an opener in the hips. And then bringing your knees back to center. Walk your feet in.